A glint pierced my eye. I wasn't speeding. 27 miles per hour should be fine. Last week, NPR had an announcement of enforcement of more speed cameras and lower 30 mile per hour limit. It's a post-lockdown thing to beware of those who sped through empty streets for years. Who could guess citizens would welcome Big Brother cameras? Glints are now on top of my list of fight or flight triggers. My coronavirus consumed bandwidth eased to allow me to return to the previous cataclysmic concerns of more comets in our sphere, mosquitoes and tick-borne diseases, floods and wildfires. The once idyllic curvy road I imagined as a winding path into Chicago now is a checkerboard of median and island curbs, with yellow reflective posts transforming a moment of nature into a video gamer's paradise. Curbs and posts are intended to slow speeders, yet also add the challenge of swerves. Mind the glinting camera. A flare of red flashed past my windshield. What I thought was a red cardinal landed in a parkway sapling. I pulled over next to Columbus Park and pulled the periscope to its fullest length and a crisper image of an actual tanager, a summer tanager. My first. It's so rare that it's not on the Illinois bird list. I opened the passenger window for a better look. A symphony of calls, twitters, chirps, staccato cheeps, a cardinal call, a blue jay caw, and Canadian geese squabbles lured me into the park by Columbus Park's Frederick Olmsted's designed woods and waterfall. I stepped into a symphonic cacophony of birds' mating calls blended into mind-blowing John Cage arrangement that melted the outside world into a distant land. Boasting speckled, striated, and copper breasts, males sang to be noticed, combining a random explosive composition. To be played outdoors, Mozart might have said. Two crows dove at a cooper's hawk, chasing it over the golf course. Glistening ripples expanded from a wood duck family with eight pinball-sized ducklings. I paused to spot a yellow-throated warbler and black-capped chickadee. A vireo flittered on the first warm day of spring, as a red start flickered up the levels of leaves and white bouquets, and a red-eye warbler flitted behind a branch. A downy woodpecker skittered up the trunk. Since I had become more finely attuned with our forced quietude, the rediscovery of birds chaotically calling out for a mate is as explosive as fireworks on the 4th of July. Over there, a birder spoke softly to another. My binoculars spun around to a swanson thrush, then a flicker. A female goldfinch, a black-throated blue warbler, or is it a northern perula? I whispered the question. Who was I talking to? I looked away from the binoculars to check. Wait, Michelle, how are you? I was gawking at birds beside my dear friend, exploring through binoculars. Where do they nest, Canada? Oh, I'm fine. I've not seen a spring like this one. There's a flock of white-crowned sparrows, Michelle said, then pointed to the right. A wood thrush went into the mayapples. We won't see that one again. A crescendo of rising and falling mating calls filled the warming air. With such a chilly spring, the birds waited for a warm day to migrate. My neck cricked from looking up. Warbler neck setting in. Everything went quiet. Birds disappeared. Poof! Not one was seen. No flitting, darting, flying streaks of color. It happens like that. It just goes calm, she said. How long have you been birding? We followed after an alighting night heron that nestled in an oak. 6 decades, yet who's counting? There's a yellow warbler in the rushes by the pond. What is it? Wait, no, a gold-winged warbler. That's my first, she said. I'll revel in that discovery today. Just as I focused my binoculars on the roosting yellow warbler, claws grasped, and the frightened bird, flying bird, a cooper's hawk crashed into the dandelions. Nearly speckled breasts below, battered wings, wings reversed its dive to flight, frantic yellow wings and talons went still. High in the oak, tufts of yellow down floated, then bright yellow feathers drifted into Olmsted's waterfall. Oh, did you see that? I said. I should be getting back, she said. What a treat to leave the world behind for a while, Michelle added while packing her binoculars. As we walked to our cars, we veered twice to peer into branches bursting with fragrant crabapple blossoms to call out a wren or Wilson warbler. I'll meet you here tomorrow. Yes, I'll be here 7 o'clock. The head rush of seeing so many exotic birds who visit twice a year pulsed as I drove straight to avoid a glinting camera that digitally caught another speeding car. This story is an excerpt from Shades of Chaos by Wright Volumes, an anthology that is coming out this summer. Please look for it on Amazon. And visit margotmcmahon.com for more information and to hear about more of my books, including If Trees Could Talk.